The top city elected officials all on board with Cure Violence. The $5 million for the program cleared the final hurdle Friday when it won final passage at the Board of Aldermen with a unanimous vote. Before that, the Estimate and Apportionment Board with Mayor Crewson, Comptroller Green, and Board President Lewis Reed gave it the green light. Reed has been the main politician pushing Cure Violence, but other people not so quick to sign on.
We've got to walk down the streets. We've got to be a part of the solution.
This was then Missouri Highway Patrol Captain Ron Johnson during the Ferguson unrest, spending night and day trying to tamp down the unrest in the explosive situation. Now Ron is a consultant recommending ways to make improvements in communities. Here's what he said about Cure Violence.
Is Cure Violence going to work, in your opinion?
I don't think it works standing alone, no. I think we've got so many programs in our city in silos, and we have to find a way of working those together and stop the overlapping of similar programs.
No offense to the captain, but I think he's out of his depth on this one.
Lewis Reed wastes no time firing back. Cure Violence essentially sends people into troubled neighborhoods to head off violent retaliations before they happen. Some of those paid ex-prison inmates and ex-criminals. It's felt they have the street cred to reach the bad guys and convince them to forego violence, thus bringing down the homicides.
The point no, that former Highway Patrol Captain Ron Johnson is making is that you're putting too much faith in Cure of Violence. That is the point that Ron Johnson is making. Is he right?
Does Captain Ron Johnson have firsthand experience in any city deploying Cure of Violence? The answer to that is no.
Captain Johnson points out that Chicago, where Cure of Violence started, has spent some $80 million on Cure of Violence in 4 years, but has severely cut back the program from 17 areas to one. You pay about $1 million per 10-block area of coverage. I talked to the Cure Violence representative.
Why is it so expensive?
I would say it's not that expensive. I would say other things are way more expensive. I mean, we look at this as being something that is investing in the neighborhood. The money goes into the staff. The money goes into their salaries. It goes into the community-based organization.
So alone, I don't think it works. I think if we look at other cities that it's in right now that are still in the top five in our country, we need programs that are going to take us out of that top tier.
I'm listening to all of the universities that have done independent studies that said this thing works.
Well, while $5 million, okay, so far, Reed ultimately expects the city to spend $7 or $8 million in all to keep Cure Violence here for at least 4 years. You know, I'll stay on top of this deal. After all, you paid for it.